plan. And I don't know.
Hello everyone, welcome to Love Variable. I'm here with the Wash Crossman. I came to give the Jaguar a quick wash. This is the Jaguar F-Pace checkered flag edition. This is a 2.5 diesel with a twin turbo engine, a small turbo and a big turbo, so I think you technically call that bi-turbo. It makes about 184 kilowatt and over 500 newton meters of torque and an 8-speed automatic gearbox. I'll show you guys the engine, I'll take the cover and show you guys the turbochargers and stuff like that. So this Monday is where I do vlog videos. If you guys are new to Love Variable, don't forget to subscribe. I will really appreciate it. So this is the second time Jaguar is on Love Variable. The first time I went to the launch, I could drive all the SVRs and the Land Rover versions. So that was the Land Rover autobiography, and I think it was the Springbok edition as well. So it was quite nice, and I'm really excited with Jaguar because their cars are so different. And why I say different is because they use superchargers on their V8, and I like that. It means you get that natural throttle response, which is intoxicating, and they also make their cars stupid loud. Basically, this video is going to be more about the Jag because I have quite a lot of editing still to do. I'm not featuring any cars this weekend. We've got Beams Bucket to go up, we've got Beams POV to go up, there's MSA coming up, there's Robot Racing, there's a couple of cool cars I'm also getting, so there's quite a lot that's going on here on Love Variable. So I'm going to focus more on the checkered flag this video. I think it'll be really cool. But yeah, obviously guys, there will be more high performance variants of Jaguar coming onto Love Variable. I think this is a cool way to get things started here on the channel. And also this car's coming in at a premium price, but a price that's not SVR price. So let's talk about that in a bit. Let's go through some nice cinematics quickly. Quickly around the car. I've been sick, like I said, for the past few days, so I haven't really gotten much time with this, which is quite heartbreaking. This is a checkered flag edition, so it's a special edition for the Jaguar F-Pace range. This color is called Yulong White. Is that pronounced right, cameraman? Yulong White. Yulong White. And I'm going to show you guys the engine. This is, if I'm not mistaken, this is a 2-liter. And I actually had to struggle to find the catch. I had to YouTube where the catch was of this car. It's all the way to the bottom on the passenger side on the right-hand drive models here in South Africa. And this is Jaguar Land Rover's 2-liter diesel, but this one is badge 25D. That is because this version has 177 kilowatt and 500 newton meters of torque. I want to show you guys the turbocharger configuration because it is really, really interesting. Oh, if I can pop this cover here off quickly. It's very hot that side, that's not touching there. So here you can see you have a huge intake intake housing and a tiny little exhaust housing for quick boost. And underneath that one over there, you see a small tiny little turbocharger over there. So this is a bi-turbo configuration. That is why this engine feels so rapid to drive. And this engine has to be one of the key points about this car. And one of the things I've really been enjoying about it is this instant power delivery. It's decent fuel consumption. I've only been getting around 10 to the 100 in town. But I understand it is a heavy car and this engine is propelled. However, on the long road, it can do between 6.9. I've seen 6.7 on the long road. I think that's a carbon DPF or something like that. This canister you see over here, which they're having to fit to cars now. It's a new regulation that's making a lot of modern cars actually slower. I see CarWow did a bit of a video on that to check if it actually made a difference to performance, and it actually didn't make the cars much slower. But yeah, here you can see is a little like a foam strip almost, and it basically helps cooling get into this intake housing over here. And obviously you have your intercooler and whatnot behind it. These 22 inch wheels are optional extra. They're wrapped in Pirelli P0s, and these are 265/40/22s. You can probably see that the disc brakes behind this wheel looks absolutely tiny. This car is also fitted with the adaptive damping. So yeah guys, this, we're looking at quite an expensive car, quite a premium car here. And you also have the checkered flag logo here on the side on this gloss black panel. Now the checkered flag version does come standard with everything black. So you also have black in the dams, a black grille, and obviously the radar sensor behind this Jaguar badge. The other thing is, on Jaguar's website, I had to actually option for the Jaguar LED technology headlights. Otherwise, you get normal bi-xenon headlamps if you do not do the LED headlight upgrade. You can probably see this little Jaguar here in the indicator. And this car is so new, you're still plastic and things like that on this car. Take you guys around quickly to the back of the car. And I think I haven't spoken about the key thing here about this car is the way it looks. I do think that this is one of the best looking SUVs in this segment currently. I much prefer it over the competition. However, you guys can vote on top if you think this looks better than the X5. I think the other one is a Mercedes-Benz ML, and there's some other odds and ends cars in that range, but you can comment down below and tell me what car you like in this segment. This one's also fitted with the optional extra electric tailgate. And I was at the beach today, so that is why there's so much sand and things here. What's also cool is you can option this car with the optional full-size spare depending on what configuration you go with. The other thing is you also get an electric tow bar, which I can hide away. Okay, it's not doing it now because I think the ignition must be on, but that's fully electric over there. You've got twin exhaust housings and a decent-sized boot. Not going to talk too much about practicality. You guys know here on Liberable, we like performance. And Jaguar is going to be sending me some of the SVR series cars later on in the year. And we can do some performance tests with those cars. And I know you guys would absolutely love that. So it's great to start somewhere with Jaguar. And I'm really excited for this. That they're starting to send me cars here on Liberable. I love this integrated brake light here in the top of the spoiler. As it looks really chic and really modern. Also these little winglets here to cut airflow, also really pretty. If I climb at the back of the 2.5 diesel F-Pace, let me move right over. There's quite a hump here in the floor because this car is four-wheel drive, so you need a prop shaft going down the center. So I fully understand that. You've also got a 12 volt socket. You've got a USB port over there, 5 volt, and another USB port over there. You've also got these things where you can put a book or something in. You've got climate control vents so you can keep yourself cool. And obviously, you see a tweeter and a woofer. This car subwoofers are fitted in front of the car. You also have your ISOFIX points for a baby seat. You also get with the checkered flag edition this 10-way adjustable leather seats in front. They are really beautiful. This one is optioned with this red inlets over here, contrasting red stitching. And also the suede roof lining really is a beautiful interior. You've also got your touchscreen over here with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. All your climate control buttons are physical buttons, so you don't need to guess where you hit buttons like on these modern digital drivers, adjustable air vents and things like that, which I'm not a big fan of. Jaguar Land Rover's PRNDS rotation gear lever. You've also got obviously your stop start, your traction control and your dynamic mode, which you can change the suspension, gearbox, engine and powertrain. So your 8-speed automatic gearbox in this car. What I like also about this car is you're on the side, here are tiny little pockets where you can put maybe your house keys. Like I usually hide my house keys in there, that I also really like. And if you look on the doors, these have a, this car has got the Meridian sound system, which I will be testing for you guys in the POV video where I drive a car. Also a DVD CD player here in front.
that's Matthew that helped me with the video now. Bye bye. See you, Matthew. Okay, guys, Jaguar F Pace. Let me cut to the nitty gritty with this car. It is very expensive. This car starts at around 975,000 Rand, so it's really starting really premium. And you can spec this thing way past 1.1 million. I'm not too Jaguar. I really struggle to find pricing on this cars, so I had to use some of the cars apps in order to find pricing with this Jaguar and what they're actually selling for at the dealership with these cars, and they definitely seem to be over a million. But what's the driving experience like of a Jaguar? And I think that's something that I really want to talk about now, because it really is something. I think I can go now after this Honda. It really is something, guys. This car feels very, very special to drive. It doesn't feel like your ordinary SUV. It certainly isn't. It has 22-inch wheels. You've got adaptive damping. You've got this fabulous 8-speed automatic gearbox. You've got metal flappy pedals behind the steering wheel. Everything that looks metal in this car is metal, and I like that about it. These door light switches illuminate like a nice greenish color at night. You have your ambient lighting in the doors and in the rear doors. You know, it's really things that, those extra touches that shows you that this is a premium vehicle. Sorry guys, this isn't a very much vlog style video, but I am trying to keep this video rather laid back and take you through roads that's nice and tight to show you guys how easy the car is to maneuver. Where this car stands out to me is its astonishing way of getting around the corner. You guys can click the card on top where I actually push Jaguars SVRs around a racetrack, and I was shocked in that video because I didn't expect something this big to perform this well on track. Check that BM. And this car really performed excellently on track. You got this big 12.3-inch interactive display in front of you. So you see the one dial over there? If I push menu now and I go to settings, I'm going to set this car to self-driving quickly. Let me see down this main road so that I can show you guys all these features. Let me just click the self-driving. There we go. Let's set it to 60 kilometers per hour. 62. And I'll just follow this car in front of me and brake accordingly. So you guys can see there it came up, and now the steering wheel also turn weird to keep me in lane basically, which is really cool. See the car moves forward, now the car accelerates. Yeah, where do you want to be, Mauro? See the car stopping. The car's coming to a stop. Oh, and that's still rolling because I think this car's going to go now. Oh, it came to a stop. I have to push accelerator now to get the car to go again. And then here we go. And this is obviously optional. Actually, you have to option this package in order to drive for the self-driving and the steering assist and all these things. So I'm talking about the display. So if I push menu now and I go to display layout and I say, give me a two dial. And I got a two dial. And then I say I want a full map. And I can get a full map. But I like the one dial. I like the speed right in front of me. I like that about this car. That's really cool. Guys, this thing's still braking and accelerating as it sees fit. I haven't touched the brake pedal yet on this car. The other thing you guys probably noticed is how quiet it is in here. Sound insulation is excellent. I have to break down myself because obviously it's not gonna see the red robot, guys. So please don't worry, this is the normal Jaguar diesel. I will be hopefully getting the performance orientated work vehicles. You're unliberable, as I know quite a few of you. Look at you making an illegal U-turn. Hey. Why must you drive like that, my bro? So guys, obviously this is a niche video. This video will probably only appeal if you are interested in a Jaguar or if you want to buy a Jaguar. What's my recommendation on it? I really, of course I like it. You know, it's so different to what everyone else is putting out. It's got a status to it it's got a premium status to it that I like. I know it's not anyone can afford a Jag, and when my dad asked me, Niaz, where you going? I'll be like, I'm taking the Jag out tonight. I just love saying that. Well, I'm going out of the Jaguar. It's such a fabulous thing. Yeah. The sound system, the Meridian, isn't too bad. I think the necessary upgrade here, guys, would be the Meridian Surround. I would highly recommend you take the Meridian Surround. This is a good sound system. Mid-range is really nice. Treble is also really nice. But it's a low end where you can hear it. It's not the full fat over 500 watt sound system. I think the Surround is going to be phenomenal in these cars. I have heard the Surround and I can attest to the Surround's astonishing sound quality. So if you are buying a car of this price, please spec the Surround sound system. Also spec the heads-up display. This one isn't specced with it. I would recommend the heads-up display. Go one time out on the heads-up display and take the suede roof lining. Really is a part. I'll show you guys the performance now, and when we get to a road where we can do a quick acceleration. So yeah, that's fourth gear. You know, these diesel engines don't stop impressing me. 65 kilometers per hour, check the climb to 80. This is crazy. You know what, guys, on this thing on a long road, you don't even feel the long road. The suspension just polishes away the bumps and Jaguar! Lekker car, lekker car. Would I buy one? I'd buy an SVR if I could afford it. Wink, wink, Jaguar. I need a long term. Oh my word. This is something about the Jag, no? Hey. Also, guys, you have this big screen in the center. I'm currently running my Android Auto, so I can have my Waze on here, which is the best navigation personally for me. I can actually see the speed traps and things like that. So I really like the navigation, big navigation in the center. The rotary dial to change the gears is also really cool. And the SVRs, I see you have a normal gear lever to go from park to drive and whatnot. But yeah, and also the quality, guys, of this interior. Sure. Another thing I forgot to mention is this is Jaguar's S-Line front bumper you get on this checkered flag edition. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you guys are looking forward for more Jaguar content here on Liberebel. I'll definitely be doing some more exciting things with the performance version on the score. I don't think it's going to be fun to do acceleration tests and things like that. This is only the diesel version. It's not Jaguar's high performance version. This is a premium car, guys. Understand, we're probably going to see comments like Niaz, but this is a premium car. It's very expensive. I know a few people who owns F-Pace and they are really happy with it. Even though some of the 150,000 kilometers on his 3-liter V6 supercharged F-Pace, and he has very minimal issues. However, brake discs and pads and tires was really expensive, and I can't imagine what tires is going to cost on these 22 inch wheels. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit thumbs up button, subscribe, share with friends and family. Be free with you, Liberebel out.